The Illinois State Redbirds entered the 2010-2011 season on the heels of a first-place regular season finish, a 28-8 overall record, back-to-back Final Four WNIT appearances, and with a new head coach, Stephanie Glantz. Glantz was assistant coach under Kay Yao at North Carolina State for 15 years and came to Illinois State for her first official head coaching position. She brought with her 22 years of collegiate coaching experience that included 12 NCAA tournament appearances. Coming into the season, the Birds had to adjust to the coaching style of Glantz, along with overcoming the loss of three 1,000-point scorers. The Redbirds went 7-3 in non-conference play and started what would be the longest home winning streak in Illinois State basketball history. For her first conference game, Glantz took on the rival Bradley Braves at Redbird Arena. The game was a tight one with 8 ties and 21 lead changes, but ISU pulled ahead in the second half, winning 83-69. The Redbirds again had 4 players in double figures, with Katie Broadway and Emily Hanley leading the team with 15 apiece.
Well, we knew they were going to come in here, and we were undefeated at home. They have nothing to lose, and credit to them for being ready to go, and credit to us for finishing it.
ISU returned to Doug Collins Court to take on Creighton. Looking to keep the home winning streak going, the Birds came out strong, taking an early lead.
It's Yachty. Yachty goes right off the glass and good. Back out to Clifton. Clifton to Broadway in the corner. Her three. Got it!
Birds held the Blue Jays off for the remainder of the game, allowing them to only come within 5 points. Emily Hanley put up 21 for Illinois State to secure a 70-57 victory and extend the home win streak to 8 games.
Now I'm spending time. You in the blind. This little light of mine. I'ma let it shine.
After home victories over Indiana State and Wichita State, ISU would face Missouri State for the annual Pink Game. After coaching under Kay Yao for 15 years, breast cancer awareness has become a priority for Coach Glantz. This night was not just about her team, but it was about all the women battling breast cancer. The team hit the court in their all-pink uniforms and proceeded to put away Missouri State. Amanda Clifton came away with her first ever double-double, recording 11 points and a career-high 10 assists, while Katie Broadway led all scorers with 19 points in a 78-59 victory. With that win, the Birds tied their best ever home court start with 12 consecutive victories.
We're definitely a lot more confident than we were in the beginning, and having games like this and beating them by what we beat them by, it's good for us.
So the challenge now is to keep our focus and to play like that, you know, in the next game and the game after that.
For the final home game of the season, the Redbirds face last place Southern Illinois and look to secure an undefeated season at home. The Salukis came out strong, but the Birds were able to hold them back, allowing them within only three after finally taking the lead. Emily Hanley led all scorers and tied her career-high best performance with 24 points, and Katie Broadway put up her career-best 22 in an 87-62 win that ensured the Birds would be undefeated at home in the regular season. The win marked their 14th home victory, setting a new record.
You know, I think it's just such a credit to the players and the team this year and just the season that they've had thus far and the effort and the work that they have put in every single day in practice. It's a credit to everyone on the team, and these three individuals stood out above the rest, and they were selected to represent really our team and the success of our team. So really pleased for them, really happy for them. They've earned it.
The first round of the WNIT saw the Birds take on Central Michigan's Chippewas at Redbird Arena. An early lead by CMU was short-lived as the Birds went on an 11-4 run to put them up by 8. The Birds held on to that lead with the help of Shayla Jackson's 19 points, Katie Broadway's 18 points, and a 10-point, 14-rebound double-double performance by Kenyatta Shelton. The victory extended Illinois State's home win streak to 15 games for the season. Baby, 1, 2, 3. The second round saw ISU traveling to Madison, Wisconsin to take on the Badgers of the University of Wisconsin. The Badgers came out strong, taking an early 8-2 lead, but strong defense by the Birds brought them their first lead of 11-10. The Badgers again took the lead out of the half, but a 12-2 run put the Birds back up 45-41 with 8.5 minutes remaining. A missed three-pointer by the Badgers and a rebound by Shayla Jackson gave Illinois State a 62-59 win and sent the Birds to the third round of the WNIT for the third consecutive year.
It could potentially be your last game, so you want to do whatever you can to get that next practice, that next game, so you just play extra hard. It's like a sense of urgency, especially when you're a senior. My life be like...
The Birds returned home to face the Duquesne Dukes for the third round. Illinois State had a 10-point lead halfway into the first half, but a couple of good runs by Duquesne put the Dukes up 33-28 with less than a minute left in the half. A three-pointer by Katie Broadway sent the teams to the locker room with Duquesne leading by 2. The Birds returned to the floor with newfound energy and went on a quick 12-4 run. Duquesne was unable to overcome the deficit, and the Birds came out with a 79-66 victory. Looking to continue both their season and their home winning streak, the Illinois State Redbirds faced Arkansas in the quarterfinal round of the WNIT. The Birds held Arkansas scoreless for the first 5 minutes of the first half and shot out to a 10-0 lead. Solid rebounding and defense by Illinois State sent the Birds into halftime up 31-18.
Down the corner, Broadway's three. Got it!
Broadway for three. Got it! Broadway wants it. Her three is good!
A late-game surge by Arkansas brought the Razorbacks to within 11, but the Birds came out on top, 60-49. The victory sent the Illinois State Redbirds to the WNIT semifinals for the third consecutive year.
We came out ready. I mean, throughout all our games, we've come out ready. And, you know, it's just, you know, that passion we have. Like, we're ready to go. Let's get it done.
That's what gives me the fire is them. I want to play for them.
The Trojans of Southern California travel to Redbird Arena for the Final Four matchup. Trojans jumped out to a 16-1 lead in the opening 10 minutes of the game, but a jumper by Amanda Clifton was finally able to break the dry spell for the Birds. A late first-half shot by Clifton
with 4, spin move, shot, good!
Cut the Trojans' lead to 8 at the half. The Birds fell to USC 63-36, ending both the season and Illinois State's winning streak at home at 17.
for this year's team to do what they have done and what they have accomplished. We ran into a great Southern Cal team on a great night. But we have a great team.
This edition of the Illinois State women's basketball team left a mark all its own with a 17-game home winning streak, an unexpected run to the WNIT's Final Four, and head coach Stephanie Glantz winning the 2011 WBCA Maggie Dixon Rookie Coach of the Year Award. In the 5 years represented by this senior class, Illinois State made the postseason and won more than 25 games every year. Congratulations to Amanda Clifton, Emily Hanley, Shayla Jackson, Kenyatta Shelton, and Hannah Spanich on your historic Redbird careers. And with talented returners and an exciting crop of freshmen heading into Stephanie Glantz's sophomore season, next year promises to be another special year at Redbird Arena.